Romovino did not need that assistance, but from Sidkus or Mischazik Volich Miatsu. Rashi says to Chazal, he explains it this way. And this I mentioned, he says, what is a tzaddik and what is a chosid? This goes to this principle, it's based on the Zohar. The Zohar says that Noach is the equivalent of Shabbos. Noach is Shabbos. So he goes to explain what it means. He says, what is a tzaddik? Two people have a dispute and they go to court, and one wins the case. Tzaddik b'din. He won the case. That means when you have an opponent and you win against your opponent, you're tzaddik b'din. A tzaddik is a person who has his struggles, but he always comes out on top. That's a tzaddik, or the majority of times he comes out on top. A chosid goes beyond. A chosid, even when he's not in the struggle, he offers himself. That's a chosid. Okay? Noach was a tzaddik. A tzaddik, because he has these struggles, therefore he needs that assistance continuously. But a person, a chosid, is beyond that. He doesn't have those struggles. Avraham Avinu, we see that he did things. He gave his life, which he was not obligated to go into a chosid. Many things in his life he did. Therefore, Avraham is classified as the chosid. Therefore, he didn't need the tzaddik. This is what he says. He says that we find that, as he says, Noach is compared to Shabbos. What's Shabbos? What is Shabbos? The Gemara says Shabbos is kufu v'kayma. Shabbos, even before it was Jewish people, from the first seventh day of existence, they already had kedusha. Why? Because who sanctified Shabbos? Hashem sanctified Shabbos. It has nothing to do with us. But the Yom Tovim, that's what the Kaddish Yisrael Vazmani, we sanctify them. Right? So we bring that about. We don't need Hashem to bring that about. We bring that about ourselves. Shabbos, you need Hashem to be involved to bring about that kedusha. Yom Tov, Hashem doesn't bring that kedusha. We bring that kedusha. He says, that's the Avos. The Avos is Yom Tov. That's Chol Yisrael, come from the Avos. So because they themselves didn't need the Sad, it didn't come from above, but they themselves, they activated everything. So therefore, they created the Kedusha. Therefore, they create Kedusha's Yom Tov. We create the Kedusha's Yom Tov. But Shabbos, it's what? It's not. Shabbos, Hashem created that. That's why the Zohar says, Noach is what? Noach is equivalent to Shabbos. That's the meaning of Shabbos. Noach needs that assistance continuously. As Shabbos needs Hashem's infusion to give its Kedusha, without it, it wouldn't happen. Again, Noach, without that assistance, he would have failed. That's the point he makes. Okay. That was one level of Tishrei. This one says it over, it's me at another level.
I didn't say without you, I would have failed.
Okay. We left off Pasuk Yudalit. Asi l'cho tevas atzei gofer. Kinim tasas atevo. Asi l'cho. Make for yourself. What's asi l'cho? Asi tevas gofer. What's the l'cho? Make for yourself. Meaning, he's not telling him who's going to survive in this. But he's alluding, it's l'cho. You make it for yourself. No question. No, whoever. What does it mean? No, there it's something else. Okay, it's a little different. Over there, it's also difficult to understand. Over there, it's also it has to be addressed. Lech lecha. You know, it's in your best interest. I mean, Avraham already was in and out of the Rakazdi. You have to tell a man like Avraham Avinu, lech lecha. You have to give him incentives to go. Right. That was a question we asked. Yeah, good, so I'm saying. But there it's much more of a question. Here it's Asi L'cho. Why was it the test? Right? That was the difficulty of doing. I mean, that was a test to leave. But I'm saying, Asi L'cho Tevas Atzei Gofer. It's really, and factually, it turned out that way. Because that was his only refuge. Without the Teva, he would have perished. Right? As it says later, why did he go into the Teva? He He was forced in by the floodwaters.
Mm-hmm.
This way, he was cut in the amana, right? He was a small believer. So it's lechof. If not for this, you're not going to survive. It's asay lechof. I saw also, the Sarsemis says that the merit, the reason why he survived Noach, is in the merit of the, he did the mitzvah of building the table. If he wouldn't have had that mitzvah, he wouldn't have merited. He wasn't enough of the tzaddik to survive. The level of midas adin was, because he says, the pasuk says, he says it's chazal, because it says, Vayas Noach kashetzivo so Elokim. Noach did as Hashem commanded him. So it says the binyan at table. He built the table. So that, in the merit of building the table, what does he did? Of course he did. Hashem said he's a Navi. The answer is not so simple. That he believed that the world was going to come to an end, and therefore he built the table, in the merit of that mitzvah, that's the reason why, in that merit, that's the reason why he survived the great flood. For that reason. So it's Asay Lecho. The mitzvah of building the table, having the emunah, I mean, it means to believe that the world's coming to an end. And not only that, I mean, that means he's going to fail. Hashem's telling him, is looting in advance, you're going to fail. You're not going to succeed. Right? We discussed this, the main Noah. That's why he had such difficulty going into the table. Why he had such difficulty. That means Hashem says, like we said, you know, when Moshe Rabbeinu said to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he says, you know, it's too much for me. I need somebody to assist me. He says, take 70 Zikanim, and I will pass your Ruach, your spirit, over to them, and they'll assist you. Remember? So there was a problem with the too many, because if you figured out the 72. So what did he do? He took 72 pieces of parchment, and he wrote on 70 of them Zokim, two of them he left blank. So whoever took the blank ones, that means they were out. They weren't part of the 70. So if you take a look at Chazal, two full, the blank ones, this God's not interested in you. Ein echor shol rotzebo. Hashem's not interested, you know what it means. You wanted the Zakanian, you think you're on top of the mountain, and you think you're there, and all of a sudden one day you wake up, Hashem says, no, something, you didn't make the grade, you're out. It's a rude awakening. Here, Noach tzadik v'del rosav, here he's given the responsibility, Hashem says, you know something, you failed, you know what the consequence of your failing is? The world's being destroyed. He couldn't go into the table. Right? Couldn't go in. He couldn't believe it. He couldn't accept it. He like went into a state of denial, Noah. So why did he go in? And they may amabel. Flood waters forced him in. He had no choice but to go in. So it's asay l'cho. So again, it's l'cho. Tables go for it, right? It's in his interest. He wouldn't have survived without. Table's a go-man. It's a go-man. What if Galfus go gopher? Okay. What?
It translates to gopher.
Yeah. No, so Rashi says the type of wood was that alludes to Galfus. Gophers are melon. Pitch. Right? Tarn. Because the water was, says, it was sulfuric and it was hot. No, it was sulfuric. Everything dissolved in the water. More than it was sulfuric. Sulfur. So the water said, why did sedimentation disintegrate? The Gemara asks, right? Why did it disintegrate? No, the Gemara said. The Gemara said, my answer is because the water around the table was ordinary cold water. It was beyond the proximity of the table. Everything was severe, but where the table was, and what about the fish? It was only the upper water. Of course, it says the fish went to the depths of the ocean. The other water was normal temperature, was regular water. Therefore, the fish were able to survive. But anything in the upper levels was totally dissolved in the sulfuric acid. Asl hotevas atze gofer kinim tasseros hotevo. You should make compartments. The chafarta also guys in chutzpah kofir. And you should. Chafarta. You should waterproof it. Mibayis from Michutz, from inside and from outside, with pitch. The reason why Chabart is we refer to it as waterproofing, because how do you waterproof something? With kofir, with pitch. So therefore, the process of waterproofing is called Chabarta. Right? Simple.
Were there boats?
Sugar boats. You have short memories. Learn it every year. Okay, we'll see. Heaven only the outside, not the inside. Only the outside, not the inside. So that's the Chazal. So that's what Rashi says. The Chazal. Okay, so the memory's coming back. Okay. So now, Asimcha Tevas, Harbe Revach Atzol Uforov. God has many means of what? Of saving Noah, the Tzaddik. Why did he inconvenience and burden with this project? That the members of the generation, they should see him being involved as 120 years. Sholonos of Mazos Loch, what are you doing? Maybe they can do tshuva. So it was only to attract their attention out of curiosity, they'll ask the question. And maybe through this dialogue, interaction, they'll do tshuva. That was the value. Atzi gofer, kach shmo, v'lo minzer, al shem gofer, shenigzar aleim, l'mochus. Kini madurim, madurim, compartments, cho behem v'chayo. Every animal, every species had its own compartment. V'chofer, zev slosh narami, matzini v'gmoro, kufra. Tevoso shal Moshe, now this is the Chazal. The box which you have Moshe into, they show here Mayim Toshim, because the waters were moving, just moving, the current. Daya b'chomri b'fdim b'zefshim michutz was sufficient, pitch on the outside and just lime on the inside, which is not a strong waterproofing. It's a sealant. On the inside you had a sealant, on the outside you had a serious coating of pitch. That's why the Moshe was only on the outside, not the inside. The old Kedishali, Riachos and Tzarek, Riach Rashel Zephis. Yeah, no one spoke of those. Because the Tzarek shouldn't smell the bad smell of the Zephis, of the pitch, of the tar. Avokan, Mimechosek, Mayim, Zipso, Mibachutz, Mibayas, Mibachutz. But here you have no choice. Because of the force of the water, it was surging upward. It was such agitation. So therefore, it wasn't enough to have it on the outside and the inside. There, it would have been better, but because there was the Moshe Rabbeinu would have suffered, so therefore we just put it on the outside. But here it was an impossibility. There, because of the agitation of the water, it had to be on the inside and outside. What are we talking about? The whole thing was a miracle. Everything's a miracle. So what are we talking about? We're talking about perception, the way it's going to be perceived. Why did he survive? He built an ark. He pitched it. It was pitched on the inside and the outside. And you see the way it was. Normally on the outside it would be sufficient. But here they did it on the inside, not on the outside, even on the inside. And over here, there's no other way to see it within nature that you're able to survive. Otherwise, it's an obvious miracle. So we're trying to conceal the miracle. By Moshe, it would have been better. It would have been better, but since that Moshe shouldn't suffer, it's survivable. The Teva is not survivable. It's a different reality. The Mabul and what Moshe had to contend with. If Yecheved only put it on, because Yecheved did the same thing, if you remember we discussed it. What was the quality of the wood that Yecheved purchased? It was the cheapest wood. Why? Because Sadiqim, Chavivim, Mamoni, Yosem, Yigufan. Because the Tzaddik values his money more than his life. So we asked the question. What's saving Moshe's life? You buy the cheapest wood. Now's the time to penny pinch when it comes to saving your child's life. The answer is the whole thing was a mess. It was a mess. Right? That's the reason why Moshe Rabbeinu didn't strike the ark. Right? It would have been an act of an ingrate. So what was the whole idea? Just to conceal the miracle. Buying the cheapest wood was sufficient. You'd have to do more than that. Coating it on the outside, not in, that's sufficient. You don't have to do more than that. You'd have to do more than that. It would have been better. Actually, Reach Tzadik also Reach Ra, therefore it's on the outside, the inside. But here, there's no way you can conceal the miracle. There's no way to do it. Because of the agitation of the water, it had to be on the inside, not only on the outside. Simple understanding. To be continued. If the miracle is obvious, if the miracle is obvious, the table couldn't have survived if it wasn't on the inside at the time of the Mabul. So it's obvious. Hashem doesn't. Only time Hashem brought obvious miracles was in Mitzrayim. It was in Nisu Galuya. I mean, over here, could have all the species fit into this little box? Not possible. How many birds do you think were in the table? It was 600 feet long, maximum. Maximum. Yet hundreds, millions of species in there. Numbers. And how many types of birds do you have? What about insects, reptiles? Domesticated, undomesticated. How? They just keep going in? How is it possible? So you have to reflect on it. But if you don't reflect on it, okay?
So everything was spelled out for Noah to the earth. Everything. How does every single bit of it are?
Definitely.
Otherwise, you won't go in that.
What it says explicitly.
Everything.
He didn't tell them how many rooms to make. You just build compartments until the anniversary of the 120th year comes. Right? He was building after that. He built the outer shell, then he gives him his building the interior.
It's
what was the interior?
Like,
Mishkan was different. Mishkan had nothing. Mishkan, every aspect had a value to activate certain forces. This has nothing with forces. This purely the concealment of a miracle. So you definitely there's a symbolism. Why 300? Why not 400? The numbers also have significance, but it's much less limited than the Mishkan. The Mishkan was even the interior, not only the exterior.